Remember when racism was solved by an action movie? HawkSchlock remembers. Here at the legendary Johnie's Coffee Shop, which recently became Bernie's Coffee Shop during election times, but in my mind it's one of the two most iconic coffee shop diner locations for filming in Los Angeles. The other is also named Johnny's. It was Johnny's Broiler Room, and now it's a big boy. But Michael Mann filmed Heat there. Curtis Hanson filmed Bob Dylan there for a Things Have Changed video for Wonder Boys that netted Dylan an Oscar. But this Johnny's was also used in all sorts of things. It was used in, the Big Lebowski. It's where the dude and John Boy Goodman are discussing how quickly can you get a severed toe. It was used in American History X. A Tom Petty music video. Tarantino, of course, L.A. boy. He used it in Reservoir Dogs, not the iconic opening diner scene, but one later on when Tim Roth, you know, it's kind of that flashback nonlinear structure where he's having a meeting with his superior. It was a center point of the 80s apocalyptic thriller Miracle Mile, which starred Goose himself, Anthony Edwards. It's one of my favorites. I think it's super underrated, so you should check that out. It opened up in the 60s during the space race when we were obsessed with, space age decor, and it closed about 20 years ago. It's only available for filming now. For me, the most iconic use would be back in the mid-late 90s. You know what I'm talking about, when two movies with similar premises come out around the same time, you know, Tombstone and Wyatt Earp, Armageddon and Deep Impact, and of course, Dante's Peak and Volcano. And pretty much all the action that happened in Volcano happens right here at this corner at Wilshire and Fairfax. I remember Volcano for several reasons. One, you got Tommy Lee Jones in that period where he just kept playing the Tommy Lee Jones character from The Fugitive. And there's some racial tension between some characters. And so at the end, there's a scene where a black character played by HawkSchlock legend, Keith David, he was a John Carpenter favorite in the 80s. You know, you saw him in The Thing and They Live. But his character is all covered in this ashen soot, and he's holding this girl, and the little girl's looking around at all these other people covered in the dust and volcanic ash, and she says, look at them, they all look the same. So yes, back in the 90s, way before 2020, we were taught how to solve racism by an action thrill ride with just a little volcanic ash. And that movie, by the way, also has just one of the great all-time taglines, the coast is toast. Unfortunately, the Blu-ray cover does not hold up as well. It's one of the worst Photoshop jobs I've ever seen. But yeah, all the action and the destruction that happens in that movie happens right here at this corner at Wilshire and Fairfax. You do see Johnny's Coffee Shop in some shots. And they actually built a 80% scale replica of this corner here in an airport hangar for a lot of the filming. And also, I gotta add that almost a decade ago, I honeymooned here, stayed just up the street from here, so I can tell you, plenty of molten hot magma lava flowed that week too, if you smell what the hawk is cooking.
HawkSchlock,